Please adjust your screen settings. Thank you. Now select your profile. When this sign is displayed, please do not turn off your console. You are now ready to begin Detroit. Remember, this is not just a story. This is our future.
Please, you gotta save my little girl. Wait. You said an android?
All right, ma'am. You need to go.
You can't do that. You... Why aren't you sending a real person?
Captain Allen, my name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
It's firing at everything that moves. It already shot down two of my men. We could easily get it if they're on the edge of the balcony. If it falls, she falls.
Do you know its name?
Does it matter?
I need information to determine the best approach. Do you know if it's been behaving strangely before this?
Listen. Saving that kid is all that matters. So either you deal with this fucking android now, or I'll take care of it. units hold positions. Airships coming in.
Come any closer or I'll jump!
My name is Connor! What about about you? What is your name?
Daniel. That's the name they gave me. Stay back!
Trust me, and let me help you.
I don't want your help. Nobody can help me. All I want is for all this to stop. I just want all this to stop.
Listen, I know it's not your fault. These emotions you're feeling are just errors in your software.
No, it's not my fault. I never wanted this. I loved them, you know? But I was nothing to them. Just a slave to get ordered around.
Are you okay, Emma?
Please help me. I don't want to die. I don't want to die.
Nobody's going to die. Stay calm. Everything's going to be fine. He's losing blood. If we don't get him to a hospital, he's going to die.
All humans die eventually. What does it matter if this one dies now?
I'm going to apply a tourniquet.
Don't touch him! Touch him and I'd kill you.
You can't kill me. I'm not alive. Look what you did! You were designed to serve humans, not kill them!
What was I designed to be? Their slave? Their toy? I just wanted them to care about me. I just wanted to matter. I just wanted to be someone. I can't stand that noise anymore! Tell that helicopter to get out of here!
Trust me, Daniel. Let the hostage go, and I promise you, everything will be fine.
I want everyone to leave! And I want a car. When I'm outside the city, I'll let her go.
That's out of the question. You're a machine you have to obey. Now put the gun down and let the hostage go.
I've spent my life taking orders. Now it's my turn to decide.
Mm-hmm.
This is the top-of-the-range household assistant. It cooks 10,000 different dishes.
Come on, Zoe, let's go.
200 languages and dialects. And handles the kids' home. Elementary school. Up to 8%.
Honey, it looks amazing. This is exactly what
we need. How much did you save, Celeste? At the moment, we're doing a special promotion on this entire range. At $7,999 with a 48 months interest-free credit. And it comes with a 2-year warranty for parts and labor. Repairs. I'd like to. It detects emergency services if there's a break-in or if it detects smoke. Excuse me, how much is that?
There it is. It was a bit difficult getting it back and working. It was really messed up. What'd you say happened to it again?
The car here. Stupid accident.
Oh, I see. Anyway, it's as good as new now, except that we had to reset it, meaning we had to wipe its memory. I hope you don't mind.
It'll be fine.
Okay. Did you give it a name?
My daughter did.
AX400, register your name.
Kara.
My name is Kara.
Thank you.
Playing God by creating machines, but we are not God. We are nothing but dust. Why do you look at me so, demon? I know who you are. I can see through you. You are the one by whom the evil will come. You are the one who will destroy Detroit. We make these androids in our own image, but they only reflect the darkness in our souls. Verily, I say unto thee, the day shall come when we will have to pay the price for our arrogance.
Identification verified. Here is your order number 847. That will be $63.99. Please confirm payment.
Payment confirmed.
Transaction complete.
Where the fuck you going, tin can? Hey guys, check it out. We got one of those tin cans here.
Look at this little motherfucker. You steal our jobs, but you can't even stand up.
Your bitch ass off.
Yeah, waste it.
Do it!
All right. It's enough. Leave it alone.
Let us teach this bastard a lesson.
damage it, I'm gonna have to find it.
I'm gonna take your job next.
See how you like it. Okay. Let's go. Come along.
Coming?
You've been gone for 2 weeks, so the place is a mess. You do the housework, the washing, you cook the meals, and you take care of... God damn it, where the fuck's the rat gone now? Alice! Alice! Oh, yeah. That's Alice. You look after her. Homework, bath, all that crap. Got it?
Yes, Todd.
Get started down here, and then you go upstairs.
Fuck, man.
Kara!
Yes, Todd?
Bring me a cold beer!
Right away. You like playing out here? Aren't you going to school today?
messes around with my stuff. It makes me nervous.
I'm sorry, Tom.
You stay the fuck out of my business. Unless you want to piss me off. You want to piss me off?
No, Todd.
You better stop that right now!
Why is she always pushing me?
I've made a good start down here. I'll head upstairs.
Do what you have to do, but stop bothering me.
Thank you. I just want to tidy up your room a little. I only need 2 minutes. Is that okay, Alice? Alice in Wonderland. Of course. I'm sure we used to be friends before I was reset. Maybe we can be friends again. Your father said you chose my name. Kara, it's nice. How did you choose it? You're very quiet. I hope I don't scare you. You should tell me about yourself. What you like to do, where you like to go, your favorite foods. That would really help me.
Ahem.
What are you doing?
I'm playing.
I know what you're thinking. Took your dad's a little life. Huh? Fucking loser. Can't get a job. Take care of his family.
Don't you think I tried to make things work? But whatever I do, when someone comes along, they just fuck it all up!
I know what you think of me. You hate me. You hate me, don't you?
Say it! You hate me!
God, what am I doing? I'm sorry. You know I love you, don't you? You know I love you.
Back to him. Who? Could not be a cleaning game, I swear to God. Fake birds? What's the point of?
Good morning, Carl.
Good morning.
It's 10 a.m. The weather is partly cloudy, 54 degrees, 80% humidity with a strong possibility of afternoon showers.
It sounds like a good day to spend in bed.
I did go to pick up the paint that you ordered.
Oh, yes, I've forgotten. That is the difference between you and me, right, Marcus? You never forget anything.
Thank you.
I just opened my eyes and I'm already gritting my teeth.
machines are such a fragile machine. They break down so quickly. All this effort to keep them going. What happened to your clothes?
Oh, it's nothing. Just some demonstrators in the streetcar.
What a bunch of idiots. They think they can stop progress by roughing up a few androids. I hope they didn't harm you.
Oh, no, no. They just pushed me around, Carl. I'm fine. Okay. We'll take you to the bathroom.
Oh, both. So have to drop.
Anything special? On the agenda today?
Yes, there's the opening of your retrospective at the Museum of Modern Art. The gallery director left 4 messages asking to confirm your attendance.
I haven't decided yet. We'll see about that later.
Okay.
What else?
All right, Wei. I went to go that way.
Just your usual fan mail. I've already answered.
Any news from Leo?
No, Carl. I can call him if you like.
No. No, don't bother.
It's so weird, a camera, like, what the fuck?
Starving.
Well, your breakfast is ready. Bacon and eggs, just the way you like them.
Thank you, Marcus.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Marcus. Television. Why don't you find something to do while I finish my breakfast?
Sure. Okay, Carl.
Television off. Mankind is so depressing. Nothing but greed, stupidity, and violence. 5,000 years of civilization just to get to where we are. Fancy game of chess.
Sure, yeah.
Speed chess.
Speed chess it is.
That's what I call a thorough beating. It's not easy for an old man to compete with a machine.
Well, I know you don't like losing, and you don't like when I let you win, so I felt I didn't have many choices.
True. We humans are complicated. One day I won't be here to take care of you anymore. You'll have to protect yourself and make your choices. Decide who you are and want to become. This world doesn't like those who are different, Marcus. Don't let anyone tell you who you should be. Let's go to the studio. Let's see where we left off. Remove the sheet. So, what's your verdict, Marcus?
Yes, there is something about it. Something I can't quite define. I guess I like it.
The truth is, I have nothing left to say anymore. Each day that goes by brings me closer to the end. I'm just an old man clinging to his brushes.
Carl.
But enough about me. Let's see if you have any talent. Give it a try. Try painting something.
Paint? What would I... Painting what?
Anything you want. Give it a try. That is a perfect copy of reality. The painting is not about replicating the world, it's about interpreting and improving on it, showing something you see.
Carl, I don't think I can do that. It's not in my program.
Go on, go, try it. Grab that canvas. Do something for me. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Trust me. Try to imagine something that doesn't exist, something you've never seen. Now concentrate on how it makes you feel. And let your hand drift across the canvas.
Hey, Dad.
Leo. I didn't hear you come in.
No, I was in the neighborhood. I thought I'd stop by. It's been a while, right?
You all right? You don't look so good.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I'm fine. Hey, listen, I need some cash, Dad.
Again? What happened to the money I just gave you?
It just goes, you know?
Yeah, you're on it again, aren't you?
No, I swear it's not that.
Don't lie to me, Leo.
What difference does it make? I just need some cash, that's all.
Sorry. The answer's no.
What? Why?
You know why.
Yeah, I think I do know why. You'd rather take care of your plastic toy here than your own son, right? Tell me, Dad, what's he got that I don't? Smarter? More obedient? Not like me, right? But you know what? This thing is not your son. It's a fucking machine!
Leo, that's enough. Enough.
You don't care about anything except yourself and your goddamn paintings. You've never loved anyone. You never loved me, Dad. You never loved me.
You just get what?
Choices are difficult. I've never been good at games like this. That's where I missed the other two. Nope, she's still alive.
Lieutenant Anderson, my name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. I looked for you at the station, but nobody knew where you were. They said you were probably having a drink nearby. I was lucky to find you at the fifth bar.
What do you want?
You were assigned a case early this evening. A homicide involving a CyberLife android. In accordance with procedure, the company has allocated a specialized model to assist investigators.
Well, I don't need any assistance. Especially not from a plastic asshole like you. Just be a good little robot and get the fuck out of here.
Listen, I think you should stop drinking and come with me. It'll make life easier for both of us. I understand that some people are not comfortable in the presence of androids. But
I am perfectly comfortable. Now back off before I crush you like an empty beer can.
You know what? I'll buy you one for the road. What do you say? Bartender, the same again, please.
See that, Jim? Wonders of technology. Make it a double. Side.
Whatever you say, Lieutenant.
Fucking anyway, what I say.
Joss Douglas from Channel 16, can you confirm that this is a homicide?
I'm not confirming anything.
Androids are not permitted beyond this point.
It's with me. What part of staying in the car didn't you understand?
Your order contradicted my instructions, Lieutenant.
You don't talk, you don't touch anything, and you stay out of my way. Got it?
Got it.
Evening, Hank. We were starting to think you weren't gonna show.
Yeah, that was the plan till this asshole found me.
So, you got yourself an android, huh?
Very funny. Just tell me what happened.
We got a call around 8 from the landlord. Kevin hadn't paid his rent for a few months, so he thought he'd drop by, see what was going on. That was when he found the bar. Jesus. The smell. It was even worse before we opened the windows. The victim's name's Carlos Ortiz. He has a record for theft and aggravated assault. According to the neighbors, he was kind of a loner. Stayed inside most of the time, they hardly ever saw him.
Stayed easy. Worth calling everybody out in the middle of the night. Could have waited till morning.
I'd say he's been there for a good 3 weeks. A little more than the coroner gets here. There's a kitchen knife over here. Probably the murder weapon.
Any sign of... a break-in?
Nope. The landlord said the front door was locked from the inside. All the windows were boarded up. Killer must have gone out the back way.
What do we know about his android?
Not much. The neighbors confirmed it. We had one, but it wasn't here when we arrived. I gotta get some air. Make yourself at home. I'll be outside if you need.
Oh, shit. Thank you.
is perfect. Way too neat, no human rights like this. Chris, is this written in the victim's blood?
I would say so. We're taking samples for analysis.
Red ice. Seems our friend Carlos liked to party.
Stabbed 28 times.
Yeah. Seems like the killer really had it in for him.
I'm missing one evidence. Oh.
Locked from the inside. Killer must have gone out this way.
There are no footprints apart from Officer Collins' size 10 shoes.
Well, this happened weeks ago. Tracks could have faded.
No. This type of soil would retain a trace. Nobody's been out here for a long time. Lieutenant, I think I figured out what happened.
Oh, yeah? Shoot, I'm all ears.
It all started in the kitchen.
There are obvious signs of a struggle. Question is, what exactly happened here?
I think the victim attacked the android. With the bat.
That lines up with the evidence. Go on.
The android threw the chair.
No, that can't be right. It doesn't fit the evidence.
The victim stabbed the android.
Your story makes no sense. You've got to stick to the facts.
The android stabbed the victim.
So the android was trying to defend itself, right? Okay, then what happened?
The victim fled to the living room.
Is not totally ridiculous, but it doesn't tell us where the android went.
It was damaged by the bat and lost some therium.
Lost some what?
Therium. You call it blue blood. It's the fluid that powers android's biocomponents. It evaporates after a few hours and becomes invisible to the naked eye.
Oh, but I bet you can still see it, can't you?
Correct.
Yeah, for sure, man. A little boring. Never played this game either. I'm not really good at them either. So.
Thank you.
Hey, 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 what are you doing with that chair?
I'm going to check something.
Gotta check something.
I was just defending myself. He was gonna kill me. I'm begging you. Don't tell him.
Connor, what the fuck is going on up there?
It's here, Lieutenant!
Holy shit. Chris! Ben! Get your asses in here now!
Better have 100%, I swear to God. You gotta be kidding me. Oh, I guess since you don't find it. Just in case you don't. Okay. Cool. Guess I did go the right way.
Dinner is ready.
Yeah, I'm coming.
There wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
My job because of androids. And I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house. What do I do? Go out and hire a fucking android. What a joke. Of course,
Because androids are so fucking wonderful. They never fail. They're never tired.
They're sad.
They're so fucking perfect, they ruin my fucking life. What are you looking at? What's your fucking problem? Not the life you dreamed of, eh? Maybe you think this is easy. Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off. You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Fucking bitch took off without a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant. It's all your fault.
Daddy, no.
It's all your fucking fault. Come back here right now!
It's not right for a father to hurt his daughter.
Alice! Daddy's very mad! That's an order. You hear me?
No. I want you to leave Alice alone.
You want? What do you mean you want? You don't want anything. You're just a goddamn piece of plastic. I think you got a problem. We need to fix that.
Come here, bitch.
have
to obey me! You're mine.
Missed a lot of stuff on that one. Damn, I fucked up big time.